Hi, good morning all. In this video, I would like to give you a brief introduction about the JavaScript framework of Odoo. How the JavaScript files are handled inside Odoo. Okay, what is this framework? It's simply an engine that converts Odoo into a live application. Using this framework, we can interact with every models or every records inside Odoo. And we can use this framework to modify the user interface also. Now, there are three different use cases which we need to consider, which are web client, website, and point of sale. Okay, we will start with the web client. This is the private web application. Here we can view or edit the data inside Odoo. An example will be the backend form view. Here we can easily view or edit the data, and the content will be updated, or it will be fetched only when it is needed. That means it is not dynamically reloaded or dynamically it's not reloaded. Okay, then the second point will be the website. This is the public part of Odoo. That means we can take an example of e-commerce. Here we don't need to sign in or sign up for making some shopping or anything. That means an unidentified user can browse some data here. The third point will be the point of sale. Here we will deal the point of sale section. Okay, then now we will discuss about how we can add a JavaScript file inside a module, or suppose I'm going to create a new module, how to add a JavaScript file in my module. Okay, before that we need to understand the assets management of Odoo. How actually we have already discussed that there are three different use cases: web client, website, and point of sale. How we will implement these use cases? Here comes the assets management. The reason behind why we use this assets management is that we don't need to load up all the JavaScript module all the time. In Odoo, we have different sets of assets or bundles. It means it's just a group of JavaScript files, JavaScript, CSS or SESS files. I mean JavaScript and style files. That's it. Now in Odoo, we have different sets of assets, mainly backend assets, frontend assets, report, point of sale, and some common assets, etc. That's it. Now, the reason behind why we use these bundles is that we don't need to load all the assets all the time. We will load it only when it is needed. For example, we don't need to load the point of sale assets inside the website. Okay. Now, I will show you how to add a JavaScript file inside a bundle and how to load it. In this example, I'll be showing how to add a JavaScript file inside the backend assets. Actually, the approach is same for all the assets. We just need to identify where, I mean inside which assets we need to add our JavaScript files. It depends, it varies based on our requirement. Okay, now I have prepared a sample module for this. I will explain the things. First, we need a XML file for specifying the JavaScript file path. First, before that, here you can see I have specified my XML file here. Inside the views folder there is templates.xml. Now we can go to the templates.xml file. Here I have specified the path to my JavaScript file. Okay, before that we should check this template. Here I have specified the ID, and the next one is the inherit ID. Here I will specify which assets I need to inherit, or to which assets should I add this JavaScript file. Here I have specified it is web.assets backend. So that means I'm loading the backend assets. I mean, I'm adding my JavaScript files to this backend assets. So my JavaScript file will be loaded whenever the backend assets are loaded in Odoo. Okay, now we will go to the JavaScript file. We need to make sure this file is loaded or not. So I am just adding an alert here. And I'm also adding a console. Okay, I'm restarting the service. Now we can go and install this module. I'm updating the modules list. It's done. Now we can install the module. By the way, I am working with Odoo version 13. Okay, now we can see that our message is shown. That means our JavaScript file is loaded. We can check the browser console also. Probably it will be the F12 button. Okay, now we can see that our console is also loaded. Now our JavaScript file is loaded. I will explain the basic structure of the JavaScript file in Odoo. Here first we will be defining, okay, in this JavaScript file we will be defining JavaScript modules. Okay, JavaScript modules means here the format, I mean the structure will be like this: Odoo dot define. Inside this define function, here we will define the module. Okay, it will be here. You can see the Odoo here. This is the global object. So if you need to create a new JavaScript module, you have to define a JavaScript module with the global object. Okay, now the first argument of this define function is the reference to this JavaScript module. So the standard which Odoo follows is like this: module name dot any description. Okay, this is the standard method followed by Odoo. So in our case it will be our module name. I'm going to replace it with our module name dot we need a description. So let us say it will be sample framework. Okay, now what is the use of this reference is that we can access this JavaScript module using this reference. Okay, suppose I am going to modify an existing JavaScript module, then for me to do that I have to access the JavaScript module using the reference of that JavaScript module. So in our case, if someone wants to modify this JavaScript module which we are going to define, they have to access this JavaScript module using this reference. Okay, now the second argument, it is a list of references. I mean list of references of JavaScript modules which is required for this JavaScript module. Okay, it is optional, so I am not going to provide it here. I'm going to the next argument, which is the definition of this JavaScript module, which is a function, and the argument of this function is require what this require is supposed to do is, using this require we can simply access the other JavaScript modules. So if suppose I'm going to create a new widget or anything, and that depends on another JavaScript module, so or that depends on I'll provide an example here where RPC equal to here I have created a new variable, and its value is a JavaScript module. I mean I have referenced another JavaScript module. Its reference is web.rpc. okay, it's just like we specify it here. I mean we can also specify the reference here. This is how we specify the reference here as the second argument of this definition. That's optional, so I'm not adding there. This is how we specify the reference to another JavaScript module inside our JavaScript module. Okay, before that there is if you check Odoo's JavaScript files, you can find this keyword. This is telling the browser to enable the strict mode. I'm not going into the details about this use strict. Now this is the basic structure of a JavaScript file inside Odoo. We have accessed the global object and defined our JavaScript module here. The first argument is the unique reference to this JavaScript module. Then the second argument, which is a list of reference JavaScript module, which is optional, I have not added it here. Then the third argument, which is this function definition, I mean the definition of this JavaScript module. Okay, inside that definition I have added the reference of another JavaScript module here. Now the next part will be creating our widgets or modifying the widgets. Okay, that is another topic. We will be discussing it in another video. I will just provide a brief explanation about that. Now in Odoo we will be mainly extending or including. If we compare it with the Python classes, I mean the Python side, there we can create new models or we can inherit an existing model. So when we the same approach is used here in JavaScript as well. When we come to the JavaScript, we are including instead of inheriting. We are including an existing model and extending. Instead of creating, we are extending. Extend is used to create a new widget. I mean, if we are going to create a new widget, there are some base widget. We will extend that base and create a new one. Instead of that, if we are going to modify an existing widget, we will be accessing that a JavaScript module using its reference, and we will be including our content. Including means we can modify an existing function or we can add our new functions to that widget or anything. That depends upon our requirement. Okay, this is the brief introduction about JavaScript framework and how we can add the JavaScript files to Odoo. Now we'll discuss about how to create a widget or how to modify a widget in our next videos. Thank you.